so much. It's great to see you tonight, and welcome to Everett Hills Baptist Church. We are so thankful that you are here, that you've chosen to join us. I see a lot of folks that are visiting with us tonight, and so we want to say a special thank you for being here this evening, and we just want you to sit back and enjoy and relax tonight, and listen, our whole intent tonight is for this just to be a time of family and songs and worship, and we just want you to feel very welcome tonight. We've got a special guest that's going to be here with us. I'll introduce her in just a moment. But are you glad to see the choir up here tonight? How about that? They're looking pretty good. And this is going to be a great, great night of worship and praise. So once again, we promise these next 3 hours are going to fly by, okay? Just kidding. It won't happen that way, I promise, okay? But anyway, it's going to be a great time tonight, and we want you to have a wonderful evening. I will ask you this, if you are visiting with us tonight, we'd love for you to take just a moment. There's some cards in the back of the pews and such, and they have a QR code on them. If you would take just a moment to snap with your phone that QR code and maybe give us a little bit of information, especially if you're looking for a church home, we'd love for you to give us that information. We just want to say a special thank you for being here tonight. And so... listen, again, just sit back, relax, enjoy some great Christmas music tonight, and we're just going to worship the Lord together, all right? Let's begin with a word of prayer, and then we'll get underway. Heavenly Father, thank you so much for this evening. Thank you, God, for this time that we have together to come into this place and to worship you. Father, you are truly worthy of all of our praise tonight. We thank you for the gift of your Son, and that's what we celebrate this evening. Lord, we're grateful for the gift of Christmas, Lord, that... you said in your word that you loved us so much that you sent your only Son so that we might have life. And so, God, tonight, may we worship you in spirit and in truth, and we give you the praise for everything that's done, for it's in Jesus' name, and amen.
Joy, the wonder we hear in the laughter, a
Stand to your feet. Let's worship the Lord together tonight. You're going to know all of these songs, okay? I want you to sing it out with us tonight. We're going to start off with the one I know you know really well. Oh, come all you faithful, all right? Let's sing it out together. Sing out now.
Oh, come all ye faithful, joyful and triumphant. Oh, come ye, oh, come ye to Bethlehem. Come and behold him, born the King of angels. Oh,
angels
from the realms of glory, wing your flight o'er all the earth. Ye who sang creation's story, now proclaim Messiah's.
Come and worship.
Come and worship. Come and worship. Worship Christ the newborn King.
so much. You may be seated. Man, it is a great, great night to worship the Lord, and y'all can be seated too. It's a great night to worship the Lord together, and I am so excited that you guys have come tonight. It really is going to be a special time together, and I see lots of friends who are here tonight, and I want to introduce, we've got a special guest that's going to be with us this evening, and I want to introduce her to you now. Come on up. This young lady is just a young lady that I love dearly. I've fallen in love with her. Many of you know that I also teach a couple of classes at the King's Academy High School, a Christian high school up in Seymour, Tennessee. And I've known this young lady actually since probably she was in sixth grade, something like that. And but the past couple of years, we've spent a lot of time together, and she is just not only... is she greatly gifted of the Lord, but I will tell you, she's a fantastic girl too, and I am so thrilled for her to be here tonight. I want you to make her welcome. Her name is Chloe Shirley. Would you make her welcome tonight? Now, Chloe, I have to say this, her mom and dad, and actually brother and sister are here tonight, at least one of her brother and sisters. And Chloe always makes fun of me because the way I typically introduce her is Chloe's dad is my doctor. And so that's the claim to fame, I guess, right? And so Tom and Pam Shirley are here tonight. Would y'all wave your hands at us? And family, thank y'all for being here this evening. Tom really is my doctor, but he's more than that. He's a dear friend to me and just a great man of God. And he and I spent some time together just the other day, and I love this family. I really do. I know that you're going to enjoy Chloe tonight. So I was thinking about some things that she could sing for you tonight. And this one, I love, anybody love Christmas music? Y'all just love Christmas music throughout the season. I know you get sick of it after a while. But everybody loves, and how many of you love the Christmas carols? You like the carols, like, Oh Come All You Faithful and all of that? Yeah. Well, we're going to sing a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful Christmas carol written by the great hymn writer, Celine Dion. Yeah, not really, okay. But this song, I love it so much. It is a song that was written by her, and I wanted to feature Chloe on it tonight. And I think that you'll really enjoy it as well. It's got a great, it really does have a great message. Though, you know what? We talk about love at Christmas time, but you know what? You don't have to save it all for Christmas Day. We can share the love of Jesus all year long. I want you to listen to this song. Don't save it all for Christmas Day. It was like this.
Just a little kiss to the
you so much. You know what? Again, that's a classic song with a little bit different flavor to it, but I love to sing songs. You know, the fact of the matter is we talk about the Christmas story, and it's all about how Jesus came into this world, and Pastor Doug talked about it this morning. He came into this world as a baby, but that there was so much more to the story. We're going to talk about that in just a little bit. There was so much more to the story than him just coming as a baby in a manger. Because the truth of the matter is when we walk around in this world and we interact with folks all around us, you know what we tend to find? I don't know about you, but I find that there's a lot of people who are looking for one thing. They are looking for hope. Have you noticed that? When you walk around, maybe someone that you work with, the people that you're around, maybe even some of your family, whatever the case may be, there is one thing folks are always looking for. They are looking for hope. Let me tell you tonight, if you're here tonight, and there's a lot of things in life that you can live without, but I can tell you tonight, church, you can't live without hope. And did you know that Jesus is the one who offers hope tonight? And see, that's really what the Christmas story is all about. The Christmas story is about the fact that Jesus came and he offered hope for everyone. For everyone. Everyone who would believe, he offered hope. And so tonight, if there was one song in this Christmas story that I could share, we shared it with you this morning, but if there's one song in this Christmas story that I think that we could offer to you tonight, it would be this song about hope. It simply says that there is hope for everyone. Listen.
Hear the angels sing, there's hope for everyone. To announce our King, there's hope for everyone. What good news they bring, there's hope for everyone. Angels sing, there's hope for everyone. They came from afar, there's hope for everyone.
Isn't that a great song? I love that. I love to sing songs about hope. But I want to do something a little different. I'm gonna introduce Chloe to you again. And Chloe, come on up. And I love, at Christmas time, one of the things I love about Christmas is I love all the different styles of music. I really do. If you were to take my phone up here and you looked at my iPod part of the phone, y'all know what I'm talking about? Some of you are looking at me like you don't have a clue, all right? But I learned how to do this from Amy Campbell. I really did. If you look at the iPad part of the phone, or the iPod part of the phone, I've got an eclectic mix of music. I love classic music. I love some gospel stuff. I'll have a little Toby Mac on there. Sorry if that disappoints some of you older folks. Some of you older folks don't even know who that is. But I love a little Toby Mac. I love a little jazzy. Y'all like jazz? Y'all like a little jazz Christmas, a little Harry Connick Jr. Christmas stuff? Okay, three of you do. And then I really love classical kind of things too. And this song, I'll just tell you guys, I wanted to do something with Chloe. I really did. Because I invited her here and I figured I couldn't. And so anyway, I was thinking about something that we could do together. And so I thought of this song. Is anybody familiar with kind of the classical world? A guy by the name of Andrea Bocelli. Anybody know that dude? Blind fella that's a classical music singer. He actually recorded this song, I think, with several people. And I was going to do, if you've heard his version, he ain't from around these parts. he's actually from Italy, and I thought about doing some Italian in this song. It's actually written with some Italian in the song, but there was two reasons why I didn't want to do that. Number one, if we sang Italian, you wouldn't know what we were saying. So that's number one reason. And number two, Martha speaks Italian, and she would probably know that we're singing every bit of it wrong. So we didn't want to do anything like that. But I really love this song, and I wanted to do this with my friend Chloe. And so I think that you'll enjoy it. And it's actually called this, but it is my prayer for you. Again, this world is hard to navigate sometimes, folks. And we all need encouragement. And so tonight, this is our encouragement to you. I want you to listen to the prayer.
Where you are.
Let this be our
prayer.
When shadows fill our day.
We are the ones who are
shall reign forevermore. And tonight, again, as I told you earlier, it's so often this time of year we think about that baby in a manger. And we think about that helpless little baby and wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. But the truth of the matter is, when we think about that tonight, we know that he was so much more than just a little baby in a manger, right? The truth of the matter is that he is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Can you say amen to that tonight?
Amen.
And did you know this, that he didn't stay in that little manger, did he? He went on to live a sinless life. And we know that he died a sacrificial death for us on the cross. We know that he rose again the third day. And right now, even to this day, we have the opportunity to accept him as the Lord of our lives. Isn't that awesome tonight? It really is. And yet, there are many, many, many people that choose not to do that. But let me tell you something tonight. I want to offer you this word. You know, when he came that first time, he came as a helpless baby. But can I tell you tonight, he's coming again. But when he comes again, he won't be a helpless babe anymore. You see, when he comes again, he will come in all of his power and glory and majesty, and every eye will see him. And those folks that even cursed his name all of those years ago, the Bible tells us that he came into his own, and his own received him not. But I can tell you, the next time that he comes, according to Philippians chapter 2, the Bible says that every knee will bow and every tongue will confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, whether they want to or not. I just choose to do it now. So tonight we want to close with this song, and I'm going to do maybe a couple more things, but I want to close with this song. I want you to be encouraged tonight with the fact that one day every eye will see him, and again, every tongue will confess that he is Lord when he comes again.
Yeah.
I could tell the whole world tonight, based upon that very thing that we just sang about. The truth of the matter is I probably wouldn't. I may begin at the manger, especially at Christmas time, but I really probably wouldn't focus there a whole lot. I would probably turn my attention more toward the life that he lived and the death that he died so that we might have life. And so if there was one song that I could leave the whole world tonight, and I want to leave it with you tonight before we close things out, it would be this one little phrase, just one little phrase. Affords. maybe there's someone here tonight, and you would say, Brother Preston, I'm a Christian, but man, life's just been tough this year. I've had a really, really, really tough time. Maybe you've had physical problems, maybe you've had financial problems, a lot of other things. Don't know what it may be. But you would just be honest tonight, and you would say, Brother Preston, when you close in prayer in just a second, would you remember me? Because I'm just really struggling. I just need a touch from the Master. Anybody like that? God bless you. Anybody else? God bless you. Bless you. Hands everywhere. God bless you. Listen, God cares for you tonight. The Christmas story is all about, again, that God gives us hope. He gives us hope tonight. And I'm very grateful for that. I want to pray for you, then we're going to close with a song in just a second all together. But let's pray. Let's thank the Lord for this evening. And I want to pray for you folks tonight. Raise your hand. God, thank you so much. Thank you for this night. Thank you, Lord, for loving us so much that you sent your Son. Thank you, Lord, for providing hope for us tonight through your Son. Lord, thank you for, Lord, just thank you for being an awesome God tonight. Lord, I want to pray for those who raised their hands tonight and said that they were struggling with something in their lives. And Lord, we don't know what it may be, but God, I just ask that you would place a special touch upon their lives tonight, whatever that need may be. God, would you provide comfort and peace in this Christmas season? For those that are hurting, for those that couldn't be with us tonight, God, would you just move in their lives? Lord, we praise you tonight for who you are and what you've done. Lord, if there were those here that maybe didn't raise their hand that needed a personal relationship with you, if they prayed that prayer, God, I pray that you would encourage them. Lord, if they need still to make that decision in their lives, Lord, would you touch their hearts and encourage them to make that decision plain in their own lives. God, we love you tonight. We praise you. We thank you for what you've done. We pray all these things in the mighty, precious, holy name of Jesus. And all God's people said, amen. Amen. Have you had a good time tonight? Thank you, thank you, thank you so much for coming. Thank you to the choir. Can y'all say a special thank you to them? Miss Chloe Shirley, thank you so much. I think you're Chloe tonight. She is fantastic. Would you stand to your feet and let's all go singing tonight, okay? Oh, come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord. All right, let's sing it out. Sing it out. Oh, come, let us adore him.